close the eyes, bring the attention inward. Nothing to do, nothing to seek. Everything we need is already within. Let's begin with the sound of Om three times to call divine attention to the self. Imagine you are everywhere. Suffering and enjoy this practice through our senses. Om Namah Shivaya, calm response. I bow to the inner light. Om Namah Shivaya. Everywhere, be happy and free from suffering, and enjoy this practice through our senses and be nourished through our bodies. Let's begin the practice. Come to standing. First, we'll begin with a mantra for purification to purify the space, the grounds, and all the psychic channels within. If you know the chant, you may do it along with me. If you don't, just think of the intention of purifying everything, the psychic receptors especially, and then you derive all the benefits as though you were chanting the words. Om pavitra ha pavitra wa sawa vashtanga topi wa Yaha smrit pandrikaksham sabahiya pihantrahas ji. Release the arms. And now we'll do some exercises to prepare the body for the practice and encourage a state of radiant health for the body. Let's start to move the head in circles. Let's try to move the body in a way that keeps the breath even and steady. And thus the breath will deliver more fluidity and ease to the movements. And then switch the direction of rotation. Keep the shoulders down away from the ears. Always trying to keep the breath, the passage for the breath, open as possible. Now just swing the arms back and forth. strong breaths here throughout the movements to energize the body and to oxygenate the blood. Now cross your arms across the chest, squeeze tight, throw the arms back with the exhale. Up over the head, roll the body down, again on the exhale, you can sigh through the mouth, two more, last one, just stay hanging, just allow the body to stop bouncing, and roll your way up, take hold of the opposite elbows over the head, squeeze them tight, biceps by the ears, inhale, pull up, exhale, bend to the right, pulse a little bit, try to get nice and deep into the stretch on the left side of the body without creating folds in the right side. Back up to the center, inhale, reach up high, and go to pulse to the left. Coming back up, release the arms. Take the elbows up to the side. We're twisting from side to side. And release. Last one, take the arms over the head. Press heels, your palms up. Inhale, lift up the heels. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, rise up. Feel the navel hollowing out. The blood will come down. Inhale, press up. Press into the mounds of the toes. Lower down. Inhale, push up through the heels, your palms. Exhale, down. This time when you come up, stay up. Keep pushing up through the heels, your palms as though you're trying to push the ceiling right off the walls. If you fall, just come right back up, remain unconcerned, keep the mindset always the same, unchanging, undisturbed. Lower the heels slowly and release the arms. Just shake out the shoulders again, and then the wrists, fling the hands from side to side, and up and down so you feel completely loose to the wrists. And now we're going to continue with a warm up with the hands in front of the heart, Surya Namaskara. Close your eyes for a moment. Remember that better than practice and even better than meditation is to renounce all the fruits of our actions. Do the practice as though it were your divine duty to all beings to transmit benefits to everyone, everything, everywhere. Let's move together as one to stay in that collective mind. Raise your arms over the head. Fold down over the legs. Bend your knees if you need to. Bring your chest onto your thighs and hands onto the ground. Right foot steps back into lunge. Lower the knee down and drop the seat low. Come into high plank. Body flat. Lower down. Knees, chest, and chin. Turn the fingers out a little bit so the elbows come close to the body. Then glide through the arms. Roll the shoulders back. Come up into cobra, uncoil the spine. Roll over the toes back into downward facing dog. Stretch the arms. Then take the right foot forward to the hands. If that lifts not so easy, lower the knee. Use a hand to bring the foot further forward if it doesn't come in between the hands. Then the foot, left foot comes in to meet the right foot. Bow down onto the legs. Bring the chest to the thighs again. Come all the way up to standing. Hands back to the heart. Inhale, rise up tall, stretch the front of the body, fold down gracefully, elongate the spine. Left foot steps back this time, first into the lunge, then to the high plank. Immediately coming down, knees, chest, and chin. Glide through between the arms, coming up into cobra. Roll over the toes back into downward facing dog.
left foot forward, again making the modifications as you need to make the movements accessible. Then drag the back foot to the front foot, fold the body down in half. Come all the way up, hands back to the heart. Again, reach the arms up, go down, don't worry about the breath, just move the body in a way that allows, again, the breath to remain nice and uniform, and then the body will move with more steadiness and ease. Glide through the arms, cobra, downward facing dog. Right footsteps, make all the movements mindful, do them with reverence, remember, meaning that the practice is an offering, a duty to everyone and everything. Hands to the heart, arms up again, go down, left foot back. To make the practice look even more meaningful and graceful, just imagine you're the witness, watching the body moving, watching the mind reactions, watching the emotions, completely undisturbed throughout the process, always just watching with unconditional love. Come up, return home, rise up, fall gracefully, make as though you're doing a dance, right foot back into the lunge, into the plank, and come down and follow through, cobra, downward facing dog. Try to link the movements together seamlessly so it looks like you're doing a dance. Feet together, bow down on the legs. Come up. Return home. Left side. Come down. Left foot back. Keep watching the body moving. Imagine you're moving with complete effortlessness, and this may transpire in your practice. Left foot forward. Feet together. The more you practice, the more steady you are and consistent with your practice, the more the ease will come. Hands to the heart. And again. Go down. Right foot back. Into the plank. Move with power, yet with grace and suppleness. Move back into downward facing dog. Right foot forward. Left foot follows. Bow down. Come up. Return home. And again. Lose yourself in the sensations. Left foot back. Try to make every movement reflect surrender, humbleness. Make every pose look and feel like an offering. Feet together, bow down, come up, and come back, pranamasana. One last time on your own, but try to keep the rhythm completely steady. Move with quietness, so as not to disturb the mind from its calm state. Move with fluidity, so that no aggressive movements, or sharp, or fast, or hard, loud noises, or whatnot, disturbs the mind from its state of calmness. Left foot forward. Turn on. Breathe in. Exhale. Remove all expectations, all attachments to the results. Release the arms. Fold down over the legs. Bend the knees. You can bring your chest to your thighs. Take hold of your opposite elbows behind the knees. And just push your body into your legs so the legs come back a little bit more. Eventually the knees will straighten all the way, perhaps. Imagine you're trying to get your chest beyond the knees. So elongate the spine again. Watch the spine lengthening in your mind. If you can, you can press the forehead against the shins, head close to the ground. Very flexible, bring your elbows towards the ground. Bring hands in front of the feet, lift up the heels, shift your weight forward into your hands, so keep pushing into the ground firmly, and then from here lift up to the hips, and the elbows, and you can jump back or you can walk back, lower down onto the belly, flatten out the toes, push into the hands, and uncoil the spine, arch the back a little bit more with each breath. Keep expanding through the heart, shoulders back and down. Now if you feel like you can, slide your hands back towards the hips. Try to bring your feet together, your legs together. Come up higher. Imagine trying to get your head over the seat. If you're more pliable, you can try to go even further. Bring your hands right beside the hips. Keep the big toes together and even try the heels together. No folds in the lower back. Make sure you don't lose your neck. Extend the neck out of the shoulders. From here, tuck the chin in, press into your hands back into downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in, pull the seat back a little bit more, lengthen the arms. Exhale, just bounce to the chest for a little bit, trying to get your chest close to the ground. Feel flexible, the head can maybe come down, touch the floor to the mat, and you can even keep it there. Push the belly towards the thighs, soften the line of the back, like a slide at the playground. And from here, bring the left foot forward between the hands, back knee down, flatten out the toe. Inhale, come upright. Exhale, drop the seat all the way forward. Use your hands to shape the lower body. Use the heels, your palms to slide the seat under a little bit more. At the same time, push the fingers into the bottom of the rib basket to raise it up away from the seat. No wrinkles in the skin underneath the hands. Bring the elbows towards one another behind the back. Allow the head to drop back. If you like, you can bring your back foot up, and if you imagine you're squeezing a sock behind your knee, you might eventually get the foot to come to the head. Next variation, sweep the arms out to the side and up, join hands together, index fingers together, Kali Mudra for the hands, Kapyasana for the pose, crescent moon. You can keep this, bring the head foot down of course if you like, to really represent the shape of the crescent moon. Chest is up, body's level with the ground in this really deep pose. But practice according to your condition. Now lead the heart to come back up. Place the hands on the knee, push into the knee to come upright. Slide your left foot in, left leg at a right angle. Extend the arms. Sukha Virabhadrasana, be mighty like the warrior. Stand tall. And then bring the left hand down, the right hand up. Sukha Trikonasana. Keep the shoulder with the knee. If you'd like to take a bind, bring the right arm behind the back. Drop the left shoulder. And you might be able to slip the whole arm underneath the leg at this point. If your hands find one another, bind them together. They're beside the seat against the left thigh, back of the thigh. Take the left wrist of the right hand if you can, roll the right shoulder back. Modification, you can just slip your hand in between the body and the leg, with the left hand on the ground. Or stay in the other pose. Come back to Easy Warrior Two. Now turn to the other side, turn forward, bend the toes under on the back foot, raise the right arm up. And see if you can get the elbow to the outside of the thigh. Squeeze the elbow against the knee, outside of the knee, pull the left hip back. And you can place your hand on the fist. As you push into the fist, raise the body up higher so the body's higher in the thigh. And the center of the chest comes to the fist. Pull the left shoulder back, look over the shoulder. If you want again to take the bind, pull the hip back, The elbow has to be in a space below the knee, so you can slip your hand in between underneath, and then the left hand comes over the back, bind the hands together underneath the belly. Whichever version you're doing, pull the left side of the hip back, head forward, roll a little bit deeper, chest facing up. Other variations, go ahead, advanced practitioners, explore your edge. Return, come all the way back around into easy warrior two. Shoulders down, extend the arms. Now we're going to windmill hands down to the ground. Left foot moves out, bend the toes under and the back foot. Glide back and forth, trying to get the hips to descend. Once you're about as low as you're going to get, push back one last time through that right heel. Lower the knee down, flatten out the toe. If your shoulders are lower than the knee, you can bring the forearms down on the ground, maybe even just the left forearm. The right forearm, I should say. But keep telescoping the chest forward. If you're very flexible, place your chest on the ground. Keep the knee close to the body. Make sure that both hips are even as possible. Take your variations here. I like to swing the arm around my body and snake it underneath the knee and take the other arm over the back and join the hands over the lower back. Extend the chest forward, telescope the head forward, exhale, settle into stillness. Fix the gaze just like a lizard that doesn't blink. Come back onto hands, pull the left side of the left hip back, lift the toes, Adho Hasana Manasana. Allow the body to just rest on the left thigh and use the weight of the body to just bring more release to the back of the leg. Bring your attention to those areas where you want to find release. That's where the prana will go, the vital force. This is too easy for you. Hanumanasana. Hinge the hip forward just like we did for Kapyasana. Bend the toes under. Start to slide the left heel forward. Just pulse a little bit. Push through the toes and the heel of the feet. Keep your shoulders over the hips. Bit by bit. See if you can allow the hips to drop towards the ground. If you're in full splits, bring the arms up. Cross the wrists. Make the pose look like an offering, an expression of devotion. Keep the body upright, shoulders over the hips, use spine straight. Break the pose. So wherever you're at, drag the left foot back, pigeon pose. Rest the left thigh on the ground. The left heel comes in front of the right hip. Just take your hands to the seat again. Create space with your hands. Raise the chest up. Stretch the front of the body. And try to keep that length in the front of the body as you come down to prone pigeon. Keep the left hip moving back. And you can rest where it's appropriate. You can stay on your hands, bring the forearms down, forehead on the fists, or come all the way down if you can. Pull the left side of the hip back. Try not to create any folds in the side body. Stay long. Creep a little bit further forward through the inhale, exhale. Notice how if your head bows, you make an expression embodying humbleness, surrender. And we're going to walk the hands back towards the body. Variation here if you like, pick up the right foot. You can hold it with one hand if you like. Just try to get your body upright and just tug
on the foot so the foot comes back further towards the ground. If you can, you take both hands to the foot. Try to stay upright if you need to. If you're tipping to one side, place a block underneath the left side of the seat. If you want to do swan pose, I'll do it this way so you can see. You try to bring the foot up closer to the shoulder. Reach across with the other hand so you can place a foot in the crook of the arm. The fingers pointing straight up close to the head. Left arm comes around and take your fingers into a bind. Last action is to press, keep pressing into the inner lower arm. Extend the arms, turn the chest forward. Try not to hunch the back, keep upright. Stay tall, imagine the swan with its graceful curve in the neck, its large wings, and just try to imitate that form. Break the pose. If you have the foot, bring it down. Plant the hands. Step back into downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Vasisthasana, right from here. Just move your left hand towards the right. Spin your toes towards the long edge of the mat. Keep your hips high. You can stay in this variation if you like. Modify if you need to. Drop the left knee down if you need to. Or go into wild thing or other variations that you know. Some of you might want to go right into Urdhva Dandasana. Slide your left foot back, hands and feet are in line with one another, and make your upward facing bow shape. Move according to your condition. To come back, again, spin, smearing the left hand into the mat, keeping your hips high, to return to side plank, right through to downward dog, go right to the other side from here. Keep watching your body moving gracefully in your mind, and this will transpire in your practice. Lift up your hips. If you want to do wild things, slip your left toes back, press into the roots of the toes. And if you want to go into Urdhva Dandasana, if you know how to get there, go ahead. Lift the hips, nice. Long curve arc from the hands all the way to the feet. And now returning, smear the right heel, the palm into the mat, keep your hips high, spin on your feet, return to downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out. Then the right foot steps to the hands, back knee down, inhale, rise up. Exhale, drop your seat forward. Use your hands again to find lots of length in the lower back. Imagine trying to pull the torso further up out of the hips. Elbows come together behind the back. Those you want to keep your seat low so you stay balanced, you can bring the left foot up. Maybe the foot will eventually find the head and the head will rest in the foot. And then take the arms out to the side, Kapalabhasana. Remember, you can lower the left foot down if you find hard to balance, or if you simply want to really embody the shape of the crescent moon. Fingertips over the toes eventually. Just imagine it, keep practicing, maybe one day the body will obey. Now lift through the heart. Come back up. Supta Vida Bhadrasana. Move the right foot back and line underneath the knee. Arms out to the side. Level with the shoulders. And then Sukha Trikonasana. Left arm up, right hand beside the foot, in front of the foot. So if you want to see the bind from behind, you can drop the shoulders so the shoulder goes a little bit lower than the knee, so the whole arm can come underneath the leg. Left arm goes over the back. Notice where my hands are. They're not over the seat. They're beside the seat, against the left, just the top of the left, the right thigh. Left shoulder moves back. Other variations, go ahead. Do the same variation as you did the first time. Peel the left shoulder back a little bit more. And then release. Come back to easy warrior two. Turn towards the front, bend the toes under, left arm up. Go to the other side, up to the outside of the thigh. Join your hands, either fist on the hand or prayer onto the mudra, hands together at the heart, or bind. You have to keep exploring your edge, be willing to go to the edge, so that one day you'll be past the edge, you'll go past it. Right shoulder moves all the way back, keep spinning the chest towards the ceiling, keep taking the right hip back and the head forward. Now break the pose gracefully. And spin the hands down to the ground for lizard. Walk the right foot out a little bit to the edge of the mat so it doesn't fall away from the knee. And then just move back and forth. Eventually settling into stillness. You want to embody all the characteristics and qualities of what you're representing. And that's where you find the goal of the practice, of the physical practice, to find steadiness and ease, which allows the mind to go into quietness. The quietness removes all the desires and attachments. Take a bind if you like, slipping the right arm around the body, underneath the leg, and the left arm goes over the back. Go ahead and try it if you like. For those who are a little bit more flexible, more seasoned. Not telescope, but bring the hands back, bring the pose, bring the hips back, over the back knee. Lift the toes, Adho Hasta Manasana. So allow again the attention to go to all those areas where you're trying to release the back of the leg and the lower leg. And that's where the vital force will go. Want Adho Hasta Manasana, drop your, pull the seat forward, bend the toes under on the back foot, evenly push through both feet, the base of the toes on both feet. Make sure that the right hip is not way forward of the other one, try to keep them even as possible. If your root comes all the way down, or even if it doesn't and you have good balance, you can hold yourself, you can bring your arms up over the head. Lift up through the heart, be grand in the pose, show and reflect devotion, complete surrender to the highest self. And release, push into the hands, knee forward so you can drag the right heel back, move into pigeon. Thighs in the same line as the hip. Inhale, come upright, hands on the seat. Curve your spine, arch your back without creating a lot of compression in the lower back. Keep pushing the rib basket up away from the seat. And then just stay long as you come forward, resting in prone pigeon. Move the right side of the seat back and settle into the pose. Lose yourself in the sensations. One more breath, telescope the whole torso forward. Exhale, feel more weight in the lower body, the hips especially, feel grounded and stable. And then start to make your way back. And maybe taking up the back foot. If you have a strap, if you can't reach the foot easily, you can take a strap and wrap it around the foot and pull on the end of the strap.
come up higher, push the foot into the hands. If you can, pull the foot towards the seat. Take the foot in both hands. So all in preparation for other variations. If you want, swan pose. Again, pull the foot towards the seat. I'll turn again around. Again, so you can see. Pull the foot up close to the hip. And lean back a little bit so the foot comes close to the shoulder. And just slip the foot in the crook of the arm. Press the instep into the arm, lower arm. And take the right arm around the head. Keep pressing into the inner arm so you can straighten your arms and eventually turn your chest forward again. Sometimes we really start to crouch and bend forward. Try to stay upright. Keep your chest open. The chest opening towards the front. Now make sure the right side of the seat is grounded to help you to achieve this. Get ready to break the pose. Pull the foot towards the shoulder and release it. Press into the hands, back into downward facing dog immediately. Breathe in, breathe out. Lower down onto the forearms. This is optional. You can stay in your downward facing dog or lift up the heels, walk them close to the elbow if you can. Lift one leg up, bend the toes back, keep the leg very bent, so the heels close to the seat. And just push off the roots of the toes, get the heel up off the ground, and just push the knee into the belly to give you a little bit more forward motion of the hips so they come over. And then if you keep pressing to your arms, you might be able to eventually push with your foot that's in the air, direct it forward. You might be able to eventually just hover there. And then if you're more advanced, you can do whatever you like, scorpion or whatever variations you know. Try to lift the shoulders up a little bit higher from the ground and come down. Rest in child's pose for a moment. Breathe in, breathe out. Glide forward into your cobra, Bhujangasana, or upward facing dog with your hips up off the ground if you like, and your knees. Imagine howling at the moon. Again, make sure you don't lose your neck and the shoulders. Back into downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out. Here, lift the heels, bend the knees, look between your hands, and try to land your feet between the hands. You can jump there, you can walk there, whichever you like. Land lightly, come all the way up to standing. Reach up high, and then place your hands on the seat, walk your feet out a little bit more. Toes are beyond the edge of the mat. Place the hands on the seat and push the hips all the way forward. Keep weight on the edges of your feet and the base of the toes. Allow your head to drop back. If you feel comfortable, you can bend your knees a little bit so the knees come more over the toes. Grip just underneath the knees. And then just use your hands to roll the thighs outwards and roll the shins inwards. You're very flexible. You might be able to bring your hands even further down, maybe right on against the feet. Then try to straighten your legs a little bit more, but keep this counter spiral going between your thighs and your shins. Make your way back carefully, one hand at a time. Walk them back up the legs. Press into the seat, pull down, and come back up. Breathe in, breathe out. Let's do a balance pose now. Let's try angel first. Slide the toes back, place your hands underneath the rib basket and push it up. And imagine you're trying to open up the front of the rib basket. So it's like a door, and like they're just, the ribs and the rib are just opening up like this by pulling it open. Take the arms out to the side,
drop your head back. Again, in the expression, a movement of abject surrender. If you feel comfortable, you want to shift more weight, really grip with your toe pads and the edges of the feet. See if you can lift the back toes up off the ground. Angel. Now in doing this, you want to imagine you're flying. So get the vision of an angel. It doesn't matter if you keep your toes on the ground. If that's where you find the steadiness and the ease, you stay there. And where it feels most like your best, the best of your best, without incurring restlessness or anxiety in the mind. Exit the pose. Move the heart to come back up. Bring the feet back together. Close your eyes for a moment. Imagine yourself holding the pose of steadiness and ease and effortlessness. And then see if that will translate to the body now. Go ahead, build it on the other side. Left toes slide back. Build the pose. Bit by bit, arms to the height of the shoulders. Open up the chest. Allow the head to drop back. Get a sense of body flight. Really push into the front of the foot. And you might be able to lift the toes up. Good. Now remember, offer up the pose and then it becomes the best of the best that you, and it becomes more of a mindful and reverent practice, a devotion of love or a divine act of love. And break the pose. Come back, breathe in, breathe out. Next pose, Natarajasana. Standing on the left foot, bring the right knee up so you can take hold of the foot. I like to hold it from the outside, and then the knee points down, the arm up, and the leg a little bit, pull the foot back. And then you can eventually re-engage the muscles of the back, the standing leg, the upper leg and the lower leg below the knee. Again, you can move your hand closer to the knee. Now, let's see if you can get the legs straighter. So imagine yourself in the pose. Come out as gracefully as you can. Whatever happens, be unjudging. Just do your best. So now we're just going to make our way down, standing at the top of the mat. Bring your arms forward, just like you're sliding down the wall with your back. Calm down. At a steady rate. No fast. No accelerations. Keep your shoulders back, engage your core, bring more weight in, attention to your backs, the feet as you come lower, so that the descent is even. And the seat comes down onto the ground. Scoot your seat back, rest on the ground. Breathe in, breathe out all fatigue. Imagine you're fainting. Lift the arms over the head. Come to seated position. Okay, now we're going to move into a twist. Lean towards right, fold the left leg back. If that's not comfortable, you just keep your knee in front with your foot in front of the right side of the seat. Baddha-Vajrasana, but we start by bringing the right knee up towards the shoulder, picking up the foot so the heel's on the same line as the knee. And pushing the lower back in so the chest comes against the thigh. And then if you like, you can straighten up the leg. Keep the shoulders back. Try to avoid this tendency to slouch forward so that you can just get the knee to the head. Just try to keep your back straight and try to pull the leg towards you. Again, use your imagination to visualize it. Visualize the little backs of the leg, the muscles there, lengthening and loosening. Keep trying to raise up through the heart, pull the body up out of the hips, make sure it doesn't fall back down. And now from here, we bend the leg, lean back so that when the foot comes down across the body, comes to the top of the thigh, and then you can just slip it into the hip crease for your lotus position with your left, right leg. If that doesn't go, you just place your foot either through the body, or if you had the modified version with the foot in front, you just bring the toes to the outside of the knee. I'll stay in this position to demonstrate the twist. Lean towards the, bring your chest over the right leg, swing your arm around, and then if it goes far enough, you can just maybe place a hand on the thigh. If you have the foot in your lotus, you might be able to take your foot. Otherwise, just take your shirt and just hold yourself upright. Inhale, lift up through the chest. Exhale, turn to the right. You want to feel the twist starting from the hips and visualize the whole spine coming into the twisting, feeling it, just eventually bring the twist all the way up through the spine. Keep pressing against the left hand into the right knee. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, go a little bit further in a rotation. Both sides of the seat grounded. And then coming back. Good. Now from here, shake up the legs. Go to the other side. Right leg folds back or stays in front. Left knee up. Hold the heel at the height of the knee, or alternatively bring it straight up. Heron pose, Kronchasana. Think of the lines of the heron, the wings, the beak, the legs, the neck, they're all long. So bring that into the posture as well in your own body. Shoulders back. And refold the leg and see if you can bring the foot into your lotus. The foot that's right in the hip crease, high on the thigh as possible, so that when you go around into the twist, you go to the left, your hand comes on the foot more easily. And then the right hand to the outside of the knee. Inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, turn to the left. Without allowing the body to fall back, the trunk of the body to fall right back into the hips. Keep on coming up higher before you twist. Feel more flexible and try to hold the ankle and the heel. Lower on the leg, on the shin somewhere. Make sure the right side doesn't ride up. Keep the right sit bone grounded. See, the chin goes over the back shoulder. And then we turn. Shaking up the legs. Good. Now we're going to come into the king of the postures, headstand. So I'll demonstrate a few different variations. Take the head down. You can just keep your hands down. Lift the seat. You can either press just underneath the knees against the elbows, or bring the feet to the outside, the knees to the outside of the arms, and squeeze in towards the elbows. And just keep the pressure between your legs or your knees and your elbows. Press into your hands and your head, and then just flick your toes up. Keep pressing through the base of the toes, so that you engage the muscles to stay steady in the pose. Okay, option one. Option two, come onto your fingertips, turn your fingers the other way, equal distance apart. Bring one leg back, all the way behind. Keep the leg bent again, so the feet close to the seat, and then just lift up the heel a few times. Push off the roots of the toes, stay more on the hairline, as opposed to going back on your head, too far on your head. Stay more on the hairline towards the middle of the head. And you might be able to find a balance here. If you're more advanced, try to peel your fingers off one at a time. Eventually you might be able to even just come on to one fingernail of each hand. If you want to go even further, try to lift one hand up. So the hand opposite the foot that's behind is the one that would come up probably more easily. So just keep on trying. And eventually just find a place where you find steadiness. Allow your body to be still and your mind to quiet down. Watch the space between the eyebrows. If at any point you need to come down in child's pose. Or four hands on the knees and just lift your seat so that you're on top of the head. Other option. Now, if you're still in headstand, come down slowly, or any variations of. Come down with mindfulness, then rest in child's pose. Breathe in, breathe out. Roll your way up.
Take your legs out in front, bring the legs out. Bring the legs out in front and lie on the back. Breathe in again, through the skin. Breathe out all struggles, whether they be in a mental, physical, or emotional plane. Let go of all resistance and all tension and effort. Relax. Shoulder stance. Prepare by bringing the arms beside your body. Try to lift both feet at the time, keeping your legs straight. Push into the arms, bring the legs up to 9 degrees. Keep pushing into your arms so you can lift your seat up off the ground and bring it back down. Not big hard landings, soft landings. Push into your arms, come up a little bit higher this time. Most of the back is up off the mat. Lower down again, gently, so that the seat doesn't come down with a big heavy thud. Come up again. See if you can get pretty much the whole back so you're mostly just on the shoulders. Use your arms to control the descent, use your core muscles. So again, descending, this descent is soft. Last time, when you come up, that was all good. Just place your hands on your back. Bring your elbows a little bit further behind your body so the elbows come closer together. Straight line from the toes to the chin. If you need to, you can tuck your knees in towards your body. If it's too much, any of these, you just move your hands underneath the seat and sit on your hands with your legs vertical, feet towards the ceiling. Keep your legs engaged. Now, wherever you're at, keep your attention on the space between your eyebrows. Watch the darkness behind the forehead as though that were a very dark movie screen and you're waiting for the movie to begin. No expectations of what to see there. Just focus on stillness of the body and mind. Keep your mind one pointed amidst focus. Feel steady here. You can bring your hands onto your thighs. Candlestick. Kalasana. Bring the feet behind the head again, bring them down slowly as you can. If your feet come all the way to the ground, you can rest your arms on the ground behind your back. If they don't touch down, keep your hands on the back to provide more support. Option Karnapidasana, you can bring your thighs against the body and the knees on either side of the head. Keep your attention on the space between the eyebrows, behind the forehead.
Make ready to come out of the pose. Keep pressing into your arms, lower down bit by bit. Keep your legs close to the body, roll down onto the ground. Keep your legs moving down. Once the seat's on the ground, at a slow, steady rate, no big, fast, hard descents of the feet. When the feet are down, relax. Breathe in. Breathe out. Allow all the tension and the fatigue to drop out of the body. Let's try couch pose. I'll just demonstrate first, and then if this is too much, you can do fish. So you bring your feet close to the seat as though you were doing bridge, and then the toes are pointing out, the heels are closer together, and then you just kind of walk forward. Lift your seat, walk forward on your shoulders and your elbows, just kind of shimmy a little bit like a snake. And then when your elbows come close to the heels, you press into the elbows, you lift the chest and the head up off the ground, and you keep holding onto the feet so the knees come down comfortably. Just keep, rest your seat again on your seat, on your heels, and just bring the top of the head down. Keep holding onto the ankles or hold your opposite elbows over the head. Fish pose variation, modification. Just slip your hands underneath the seat. Press into the lower arms, lift the chest, and the top head comes to the ground. Now, wherever you're at, breathe very fast, like a panting dog, through the nose. Resume normal breathing if you're in couch pose. Put your hands beside your head, with the fingers facing towards the feet. Move your hands a little bit further out, to slide your head a little bit more. If you can, press into the base of the toes. Some of you might be able to come right into Urdhva Dhanurasana from here. If not, just move yourself into a position where you can come into the pose. You keep your head on the ground if you like as well. If you're in fish pose, you want to try to Urdhva Dhanurasana. You would just come into your bridge. Your heels close to the seat, and then you just come onto your fingertips, pull your head back, turn your hands around, and you continue the rest of the way. Either stay there or take your head up off the ground. If you're in Urdhva Dhanurasana, just try to stay up. Practice endurance. Try to get out of the head. Try to keep your mind free of the restlessness or the doubts. Just give it a try. And when you're ready, come down. Walk your hands a little bit further forward so you can make your descent more easily, and come down on your back. From here, breathe in, breathe out. All fatigue, relax. And slide the feet a little bit closer to the, with the feet flat on the ground, closer to the seat. Raise the right leg up, take hold of the ankle, and pull the knee onto the shoulder. And then pull on the foot a little bit so the foot comes close to the head. So you stretch the back of the leg. If you can, you can extend the left leg. If you're more flexible, keep pulling the foot closer to the head. You're very flexible, you might be able to come. Bring your foot right down beside your ear, but try not to shorten the right side of the body too much. Keep dropping the right, rolling the right hip down so that both sides of the torso, the trunk, are the same length as much as possible. Okay. So again, bring all the attention to those areas where you want to find more release. From here, you come out of the pose, release the foot, bring it down. Take one breath in. Breathe out all fatigue, all impressions. Start anew, and like you're beginning a new experience. Right foot slides in if you need to start, and bring your left knee to left shoulder and work the pose. Now have no expectation that this side is going to feel exactly the same as the other side. Just keep cultivating awareness and keep working the side that gives you more trouble, maintaining what you have on the other side. Always trying to keep your body as balanced as possible. Okay, so again, do as much as possible the same variation with, again, those respect your limits and taking into account the imbalances. And be unconcerned regardless. Pose, bring the foot back down, breathe in, breathe out, arms over the head, and come up to seat position. Okay, so now I'm going to hinge forward, bend your knees a little bit, bring your feet so the soles of the feet are facing forward, and just slide your forearms underneath the legs, grip the outer edge of the feet. Walk the seat back, so make sure both sides of the seat are grounded. Working towards tortoise pose. So create fullness in the back body by imagining trying to push the belly button against the lower back, and then bring the forehead down to the ground or towards the ground. Make your back look like a big tortoise shell. Inhale, lengthen from the base of the spine to the top of the head. Exhale, feel the shoulder blades falling away from one another. Press the knees outwards towards the ground. Tugging on the edges of the feet, the outer edges of the feet. Inhale, come back up. Exhale. Slide your feet in, place your hands beside your seat, and come up. Trying stork pose now. Keep your seat at about the height of the knees. Wrap your arms around the outside and through in between. Press outwards into the inner shins, and then you can either stay here if this is where you're at, or lift your seat, slide your arms down a little bit. See if you can bring your hands to cup your ears. You might be able to get your hands all the way around until they interlace behind the head. Lift the seat as much as you can, and concentrate on the base of the spine. And from the base of the spine, lengthen your spine. Pull on the head a little bit more so it comes further through, so you feel a stretch in the back of the neck. Exhale, release. Inhale, come up a little bit out, forward, exhale. Drop down and ragdoll. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now from here, bring the left shoulder in behind the left knee. Take your hand onto the seat, left side of the seat, right arm comes around. See if you can take hold of the hands. If you can't do that quite yet, you just press your forearm against the inner right thigh and just pull the right side of the seat up. So eventually get your shoulder go open up, and then eventually can get your shoulder underneath. And then go to the other side. Come back first, inhale, extend forward a little bit, exhale. Drop down, and then bend your knees. Especially the right side drops a little bit more. Maybe the right arm can come over the back. And the left arm over the back. Just underneath the right arm underneath the leg, right arm over the back. And try to lift the left side of the seat. Try to keep your head close to the ground and eventually straighten the right leg as well. Break the pose. Inhale again, come back through the middle. Exhale, flop down.
from here. Come forward. Bring your shoulders in behind both of them if you can. Bring your hands. If you need to come on fists, it's okay. And then drop your seat down. But if you can get your hands flat on the ground, that's more ideal. Lower the seat down. You're squeezing your arms, your shoulders from behind and in front with your backs, your legs close to the knees. Hinge forward if you can. Body level to the ground. Walk your feet further forward. Keep pressing the backs of the arms into the backs of the legs. And then, if your body's level to the ground, keep pushing your hands. You might be able to lift your toes up. Titibhasana. Lift up your seat a little bit so that you don't fall back. And from here, come out of pose. Come down into which way, maybe fall back on your seat, or you come out and you sit down. Hug your knees to the chest, breathe in. Breathe out slowly. Now we're going to come onto our belly. Just bring the forehead onto your hands, stack the hands, breathe in. Breathe out. Getting ready for cobra, slide your hands back in line of the heart, in the line of the heart. From here, anchor down to the tops of the feet, roll the shoulders back. If you find your legs start to creep out, so they look more like feet than a tail, you can cross one foot over the other, one ankle over the other. Now push into the hands, roll the shoulders back. Come up slowly, push the chest forward, away from the seat. You don't have to come to your max when maybe the first time, just explore where your breath will take you. Imagine you're in a body of a snake, move just like the snake moves. Walk your hands a little bit closer if you can to the body. Get a little bit more height while still keeping your hips on the ground. Breathe in, breathe out, relax, and then the other foot goes over on top this time. If you cross your legs or ankles, come up again, visualize yourself only as a snake now, become one with the cobra. Imagine the wings beside its head, and then just open up through the heart. To make yourself look like the king cobra. Roll down bit by bit. Breathe in. Breathe out. Relax. Okay, now next one. Doing the real pose that we call king cobra. So this time you do open up your legs. You try to bring your feet to the head. So you slide your hands back. I like to come onto the fingertips. Start the ascent as you would into cobra. Then get your hands as close to your hips as possible. Slide the hips. Get as upright as possible. Try to imagine your head, your spine straight. And then raise your feet up. Imagine you're squeezing the socks behind your knees and the toes up. And maybe they find a head. If you're more advanced, move one hand towards the center of the body. And can try to move one hand to the thigh and then the other hand to the lower leg, just below the knee and the other one. Bound king. You really push through the thighs towards the ground until if you're down and move one hand at a time. So you come out of the pose with control. Breathe in. Breathe out. And then in, press into your hands, come up into seated position. Final twist. Left knee in front. I'll do it this way, facing you so you can see the foot on the just a heel on the outside of the right side of the seat, and the left, the right leg over across the other side. If this is not doable without your one side coming up off the ground, you extend the left leg. You slide your foot, your right foot, a little bit further out, away from the hip, closer to the ankle. I'll do this variation first. Right hand behind the back, right down the center of the back. Left arm up, and then press the forearm against the thigh, the outside of the right thigh. Inhale, push the lower back in. Exhale, use the elbow to pull the knee further beyond the left edge of the body. Turn towards the right. Keep the left leg active. Push up through the heel. Advanced variations, if you know them, go ahead. Again, always just come to the edge of your potential. Always give the best that you can. You have to keep going to the edge in order to go past, as Dharma says. And come out of the twist. Other side. Right leg comes in front, right knee just down the center line of the body, right leg over to the other side if you're doing a full Adamatyendrasana. Right arm up, and then go into the twist. Out to the outside of the left thigh, push the lower back in, the hand is right behind the seat. If it's further back, you'll lean back and you won't get the full benefit of the pose. So sit upright and straight as possible. One, slip the right arm through underneath the knee. You can bind your left wrist with your right hand. Push the lower back in, rise up tall. Exhale, go a little bit deeper to the stretch. Release and come out of the pose and lie on your back for Shavasana. Then bring yourself into a position as conducive to completely relaxing every part of the body. Just allow the feet to fall outwards, the hands to just come to rest a little bit away from the body with the palms facing up. And then just feel so the body which is sinking into the ground heavily. All the effort and tension falling away. Any resistance that you feel, mental, physical, emotionally, or in emotional sense, let it all go. To the point where eventually you lose complete awareness of the body. You just become again that witness, just watching the form in its still position. And allowing all the benefits of the practice now to integrate into the body. All the love that you put into practice and that all yogis everywhere put into their practices. Bring it into your own being. Make it an offering to the highest self, to God, who resides in the spiritual heart, in the center of the chest. Doing so, you reach all beings, for we are all connected through God, through that divine spark that resides in each and every one of us.
start the process of re-entering back into awareness of the body. Feel the breath. Become aware of the fingers and toes. Awaken the body gradually, ever so mindfully, reverently, and quietly, in order to preserve the serenity that we created. So move in a way that allows for that quietness of mind and body to stay with you as you transition back to a seated position. Do some pranayama in order to quiet the mind, which makes it more conducive to meditation. Alternate nostril breathing, the count is 4, 16, 8, so 4 on the in-breath, 16 on the hold, breath retention ends, 8 on the exhale. Left hand in Dhyana Mudra, index finger and thumb tips touch together, other fingers extended on the left knee, other hand Vishnu Mudra. Two peace fingers fold down, and we use our right thumb to control the passage through the right nostril, right ring finger through the left nostril. So inhale through the, as you find the active nostril first by breathing, inhale and exhaling rapidly through one side first, and then the other side, see which one feels more free, and that is your active side, the one that seems more clear. If they're both the same, default to the left side, it's your active side. So we'll just count this through for you. And so we're breathing in through the active side, holding for the count of 16, engage the throat in the root lock, and then hold the attention at the space of the, between the eyebrows. Exhale through the less active side, inhale immediately through the left less active side, holding again with the locks in place, exhale through the other, the active side. That's one cycle. So let's give it a try. Sitting up tall and straight, breathe out first to empty the lungs. Then bring the close off the less active side, inhale through the active side, 2, 3, 4. Close both sides of the nose, hold the breath, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Exhale through the less active side, 2, 3, 4. Remove all the tension from the locks, 6, 7, 8. Inhale through the less active side, 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath, attention at the third eye, throat and root lock, tongue to the tip of the tongue to the upper palate behind the teeth. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Exhale through the active side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale through the active. 3, 4. Hold the breath. Chin against the chest. The chest should be nice and high. 16. Breathe out through the less active side. Release the locks. 5, 6, 7, 8. Breathe in through the less active side fully. Hold the breath. Breathe out through the active side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Breathe in, active. Hold the breath for 16. Relax the face. Exhale through the less active side. Inhale through the less active fully. Hold the breath, throat lock, root lock, third eye focus. Exhale through the active side.
Continue on your own, keeping the count of 4, 16, 8, very steady. Next time you breathe out through the active side, conclude. Once you're done, the right hand also in Yana Mudra, sitting up tall, supremely still and erect. Seedless meditation. Study the self. Stay in the mindset of the observer, the witness. Watch just the activity of the mind without any concern of what's passing through the mind, without any attempts to stop the thoughts or to censor or to analyze the thoughts. Observe the emotions. Remain undisturbed, unjudging. You are not the body, nor the mind, nor the emotions. Eventually, you become completely unaffected by whatever circumstance you're in as well. You train your mind to be quiet, like that observer that's watching everything and recognizing that these are all just experiences that help us to grow our knowledge that we need to bring ourselves out of the place of suffering. Shanti, Shanti. Be receptive to the divine light within, the grace of God. This concludes our practice. Thank you so very much for joining this morning. Namaste. Appreciate your openness and receptivity to let me start early today. Have a wonderful day. I hope to see you soon.